The word will produce. Matthew chapter 13 and verse 23. But he who received seed on the good ground is he who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and produces, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. As we close out this week, where we've been considering the parable of the sower and drawing simple yet powerful and important insights from the parable of the sower for us to have the word of God produced in our lives, we close off this week by assuring ourselves that the word of God will produce in our lives. In Matthew 13, verse 23, where Jesus said that the seed that fell on good ground, he said it indeed produces and bears fruit. It indeed will produce and will bear fruit in your life. You see, every seed has been designed to produce after its own kind. The life in the seed, though it may seem dormant and it resident inside the seed, is waiting to be released and waiting to come forth out of that seed and multiply itself on the earth. Similarly, the word of God is full of life, it's full of power, and is waiting for it to bear fruit, produce in your life. So as you and I consistently, intentionally receive the seed of God's word into our hearts, that word will produce in our lives. When the angel came and spoke to Mary, saying, Mary, you're going to have a child, and the power of the Holy Spirit will come on you, and what's birthed in you is the Son of God. Mary's response was, be it unto me according to your word. Or the literal translation would render it like this: no word from God is void of power for fulfillment. No word from God is void of power for fulfillment. Every word of God contains within it the power needed to produce. Indeed, the word will bear fruit and produce in our lives. As we are familiar with Hebrews 4 and verse 12, the word of God is alive and full of power. It will produce in our lives. So if you need healing, there is a way to receive healing. You take the scriptures, the promises of God concerning healing, you meditate in it, and the word concerning healing will produce healing. Take the word of God concerning financial provision, meditate in it. That word will bring forth financial provision in your life. Take the word of God concerning promises for your family, for your marriage, for your children, for your future, for your job, for your career, for everything else that God has promised, for the miracles of God, for the deliverances of God. You take those promises, you meditate in it, put it into your heart, because the seed will produce after its own kind. The promises of God has been designed to produce in our lives. We are God's garden. Our heart is the ground. The seed is the word. He has released his word to us, given it to us by the power of his spirit. Now we must receive that word and have this confidence that the word will produce. Indeed, the word will bear fruit and produce in your life and mine. If we just follow the principles, the truths, the insights Jesus gave us in the parable of the sower, there is no reason why you and I will not see a 30-fold, a 60-fold, or a 100-fold harvest of what we sow. Let's engage with the principles of the kingdom, because Jesus spoke it and revealed it to us. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this truth, this parable that unveils the principles of your kingdom to us. Enable each of us to engage with your word in such a manner that we will see the word indeed bear fruit and produce 100-fold all the time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.